Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining me. Looks like we caught Old Faithful going off. Behind Old Faithful, you notice this hill here. Let me bring it up a little bit so you can see it a little bit better. That is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. Most volcanoes only have one resurgent dome, but Yellowstone has two areas where the ground has risen up because of the magma recharging into the system. USGS has 46 earthquakes reported for the last week. We got one up past Bozeman, and there's another one down here by the Grand Teton. The largest was a magnitude 2.0 by Earthquake Lake, Hedgen Lake, a depth of 12.0 kilometers. So that's about 7.4 miles below sea level. And all earthquakes are measured from sea level. And that was on the 11th of this month. So I thought I would add Earthquake Lake's monitor to my list of monitors that I'm showing. That is the one here on the left. The next one is Denny Creek. The second to the right would be Little West Thumb. And then on the far right, we have Lake Butte. Going to Google Earth, here's a location for that earthquake station. This lake was created by an earthquake that happened in 1959 that created a huge landslide, killing many people, blocking off the river and thus creating the lake up behind it. There you can see it right there. Going down below over here, let me bring it down. Here we have Denny Creek. The little star is the epicenter of that earthquake in 1959. This yellow thumbtack is the location of the magnitude 2.0 earthquake. On November 25th, this is location of a magnitude 3.1 earthquake. This area of the fault zone, you notice how it's broken. Yeah, the fault has been broken and there's different blocks being shoved up in different locations. This too is an area near the Snake River Plateau where magma is coming up under the ground and going up to the caldera, and drawn out in red is the Caldera Rim of Yellowstone. I have drawn out a lot of different things on here. I got the areas of past eruptions. This is the Henry's Fork Caldera. That eruption was about 1.3 million years ago. In light blue, which is much larger, I don't know if you can see it. Goes all the way up around here, down through here, if you can follow my hand. That is the Island Park Caldera. Scientists figures that erupted about 2.06 million years ago. But there's been more recent eruptions. Let's see. Let me bring it down. We got Hell's Half Acre. And also close to this area is Craters of the Moon. Now, Craters of the Moon, that eruption, you can see it all in black. That was only about, 10,000 years ago. There's been about 40 smaller eruptions since the last major eruption. And yes, there is also rhyolite deposits within this area from these eruptions. So you could get a dike intrusion. We could have a smaller eruption anywhere coming up where the plume comes up from. Many of the scientists do not agree about the Yellowstone plume and where it comes from and what direction it goes. Here's an image from 2013. This is of the Snake River Plateau. Another image taken from magnetotelluric data. This one is looking down, and the arrow here is the direction of the North American plate. So there's a lot more to the plume that comes up, heating up the ground in different directions than the cartoon image that they most recently published of the Yellowstone Caldera. I guess you could say that some of these are the pockets of melt. Every time they get some university to go out and do the research for USGS, they keep finding out that it's bigger and bigger than what they originally thought. So again, this is magnetotelluric images up to about 50 kilometers in depth. So this would be about 31 miles below the surface of the Snake River Plateau and Yellowstone. So this is the latest image, the spectrogram of the earthquakes that I pulled. Again, earthquake lake on the left, Denny Creek here next to it, Little West Thumb, and Lake Butte on the right. So I'm going to show you an image of Denny Creek, and I want to show you the location of Denny Creek right there. All right, let's bring this out. And we got the location of the 1959 earthquake. And we got the spectrogram. Now this is from 1650. We got two lines of melt like I talked about before. There's more than likely cracks allowing the magma to flow up. And because of the rhyolite cap, not all rock melts at the same temperature. The magma is moving horizontally. And then it finds another spot to melt the rock and finds another crack and slowly rises closer and closer to the crust of the earth. There is pockets of melt only 600 feet under where people have been walking. This is why at times they have to close off different sections of the boardwalk, because it gets so hot. Oh, the camera stopped working. It would probably melt their shoes, melt the tires on your cars, and have unhealthy gases to breathe in. The monitor from Little West Thumb. Yeah, we got a few marked in red here. It also, too, has two lines of melt with pockets of melted hot rock in the center between the two. Let's go over here and take a look at this. Yeah, those are the most recent ones in red. And let's take a look at the signature. 9 o'clock universal time. And these are what's called volcanic earthquakes. You get that when magma's on the move. So here's the earthquake signature from the four different monitors. Yeah, look at Denny Creek. Let's make that one bigger. Yeah, this is what's called a screw wave. Yeah, look at that. Now it comes up from that area. It moves off across the park. I've talked about the two different directions, one being the Snake River Plateau and the other from the Gulf of America coming up on the east side of Yellowstone Lake. Interesting signature, isn't it? All right, and it's pretty thick throughout that whole time. Let's go backwards a little bit. Each line is a half an hour. Let's take a look at the signatures. Yeah, we had magma coming into the system. Look at that. And they'll tell you, oh, the monitor was acting up. Wasn't working correctly. Yeah, we got some other signatures. See how it started changing when we had the series of small earthquakes? See, an earthquake lake was also showing a series of small earthquakes, actual drum beats. Let's look at the spectrogram. Yeah, look how hot that is. And then it settled down. But we still have, let me pull it down for you, we still have the hot pockets of melt. This, too, is an area, I want to make it very clear, where the magma is much deeper under the caldera. This is outside what they consider the caldera rim. So it's not as brittle, the ground is not as brittle as it is in the center of the caldera. So I'm going to go to Little West Thumb. We got three different sections here. Marked in red, which means the computer picked up the earthquakes. And I've talked about the sharp popping of the rock that's occurring there. And we'll look at the spectrogram and the heat that came up. Okay, 1555. And remember, this is an area, or the area, where the magma is much closer to the surface of the ground. These earthquakes were not reported, even though they are on two different monitors. Here we have Little West Thumb, and this here is Lake Butte, which is on the eastern side of Yellowstone Lake. All these are showing up. Yeah. They do not want you to know what is currently happening there at Yellowstone. Let's see what it was showing when I pulled the files. Yeah, see, it settled down a little bit. They don't want you to be prepared. Those that are prepared, more likely they would come in and take from you what you have. Yeah, there's some major stuff coming. I am not going to be one bit surprised if food rationing isn't going to be happening, along with rationing of other goods soon. Not because of this. I have no idea what they are pulling or why they're pulling it, but they're going to make it impossible for you to go out and buy unless you have the vaccine. And then they're going to make it where you can only buy two of each item, so you cannot go out and buy goods for your neighbors or your other family members. That's coming too. Right here at 157, that's where it was screaming again. When it screams, what I'm talking about is the rush of the magma coming into the system is so fast and so loud that the monitors can't pick it up. So it goes silent. Flatline. Over here is Little West Thumb. Up over here is Lake Butte. Right there. Let me zoom in. Two different monitors. And what I need to do is find a monitor that's closer to this area here, this heated zone, where Bob Smith, who has worked for the University of Utah, maybe, 50 years? He feels that the next eruption will occur. Hopefully it's going to be a small eruption. Hopefully it's not going to be a large eruption. In my last one, I talked about the earthquakes that were occurring over here by the Sour Creek Research Dome. That's the one in yellow. And then the Mallard Lake, which I don't have it drawn out. I just got the location. That's the one you see on the live webcam. Looks like they're currently looking at Beehive right now. Usually this side little vents before Beehive. Yeah, and the camera is just crap, okay? It's crap. Used to be so much better. But anyways, that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.